Hi everyone, we were seeing transistor as an amplifier in the last video. So we are continuing that discussion here. We were seeing one diagram. I told you how transistor amplifying the signal. That is, in this region, emitter base, that is this shaded region, emitter base junction as well as base collector junction will be reverse bias. But this region, emitter base is forward bias, but base collector is in reverse bias. But that reverse bias is maximum at here, means here reverse bias, the depletion region width, that is too much high, it won't permit, or it is permitting very small value of current to pass through this one. But as you moving from this point to this point, current is increasing, meaning is this depletion region width is decreasing. If at this point, if depletion region width is this much high, when you are moving to the left and top direction, this width is decreasing like this. Again, if you are moving at this point, that depletion region width will be very, very small, somewhat like this. That is, both are in forward bias. When depletion region width is decreasing, correspondingly, the voltage we can take across these two terminals will decrease, but current will increase. So base is actually acting as a tap. Base current is acting as a tap, and it is controlling the width of this region so that the current flow through this region is changing. So actually, in amplifier, you may remember the first definition, what we were saying, amplifier, it is an electronic circuit, it take the DC value, DC power, and give, by using that DC power, amplifying the input signal. So imagine the case that what I am trying to convey. Before we are coming to that one, we can go one important concept. After that, I'll explain. Okay. So, we have seen this concept. So, this point, 13 volt, 4 milliampere, 12 volt, 10 milliampere, 10 volt, 20 milliampere, 8 volt, 30 milliampere, 6 volt, 40 milliampere, 4 volt, 50 milliampere, 0 volt, 60 milliampere. Actually, it's a Cartesian coordination system. Two points are there, VCE and IC. This VC and IC, all possible value of VC and IC in the active region or at the between the cutoff and saturation region. If we are joining all these points, that will give a line, and that line is known as load line. Very, very important concept. This load line, actually it is applicable for every device, and load line actually is the locus of all point. Understand? Locus of all point, and that point is formed with the output voltage and output current. If you are taking what is the present output voltage and present output current, then you are changing the input. What is the corresponding present output voltage and present output current? Again, changing the voltage for 1 volt, it is here 0 volt and 0 ampere and 14 milliampere. 2 volt, it is 13 volt and 4 milliampere. 3 volt, it is 12 volt and 10 milliampere. 4 volt, it is 10 volt and 20 milliampere. Like that, you increase up to 20 volt. Then now it becomes as 0 volt and 60 milliampere. All these possible points, VC and IC, and locus of all this point, if you are connecting all this point, it will be a straight line. That straight line says as load line. Actually, load line gives all possible value of output voltage comma output current. Means for this circuit, which are the maximum voltage and minimum voltage it can take, correspondingly there would be minimum current and maximum voltage. That depends on the base. For a transistor, when voltage is maximum, current is minimum. So for what is the maximum voltage comma minimum current, from there to minimum voltage comma maximum current, that line. What is the importance of this line? Important of this line, for 2 volt, what should be the amplification you are expecting? That you will get from here. Or 3 volt, what is amplification you are expecting? That one you will get from here. Okay. So, the slope of this line, that is giving the gain. Exactly. Okay. Then, so like that, combination of all this load line, this point we are saying as a load line. And the point on this load line generally known as operating point. Operating point means at which voltage comma current it is operating. Means if you are giving 3 volt here, correspondingly it is maybe 12 volt comma 3 milliamp, 10 milliampere. 12 volt comma 10 milliampere. So this is the operating point of this device for biasing, that is you are setting the DC value here. So by setting a particular DC value here, you can set a operating point on this load line. Depends on the which voltage or current you are setting here, correspondingly a particular output voltage comma output current you can set on this line. That point is known as Q point or operating point. Then what is important of this one? That one, if you want to understand, take another case. Anyway, I think you are clear. By changing the voltage here, you are able to change the output voltage and output current, and its maximum is, maximum current is here and maximum voltage is here. Minimum current is 0 and minimum voltage is 0. Then you take another example. See, this diagram, it is nothing but actually the same diagram what we were seeing there, that is this one. And instead of here, I am giving the transistor as such, and that load line I have placed here. Imagine the case, this VBB you have set as 7 volt. Okay, this VBB, sorry, not this VBB. Okay, this VBB you have set as 7 volt. Then you are giving a voltage here, 2 and minus 2 voltage. Okay, then these 2 voltage together comes to the input of base, that is VBB plus this VS, that is 7 volt plus this 2 minus 2 voltage together comes to this base. Then it will behave somewhat like this, isn't it? It is behave somewhat like this. Okay, means in the previous case we are giving only 1 volt. If I am saying it is 3 volt, that 3 volt is constant. If I am saying it is 1 volt, that 1 volt it was constant. If I am saying 7 volt, that 7 volt was constant. But now I am giving a AC signal also along with that VBB. Then it is voltage is, this AC signal is start to oscillate with respect to VBB. Means its voltage is increasing to 9, decreasing to 5. Again increasing to 9, decreasing to 5, like that. Then see, what will happen if voltage is increasing here? When voltage is increasing here, current is increasing. When current is increasing, what will happen? Current here it is increase. Correspondingly, you will get, for say, if this 9 volt, I am taking as an example, for this 9 volt, correspondingly Q point is somewhat here. So, correspondingly, it is for this 7 volt, Q point is somewhat here. For this 7 volt, Q point is somewhat here. When it is increasing to 9 volt, current is increased. Means current is increased from this point to here. now current become 40 milliampere. Correspondingly, voltage is decreased to this 3 volt. Then again, voltage is decreasing here. Now it has become 5 volt. Correspondingly, current is decreasing here. When current is decreasing, IC is decreasing. Then IC is decreased to 20 milliampere, but voltage is increased up to this 10 volt. If you are increasing this, increased value signal is given here. Means another signal, the high amplitude is given here. Correspondingly, a high amplitude signal will be come here, like this. And its amplitude will increase up to this much and up to this much. Means whenever you are giving a oscillating signal with the DC at the input, corresponding that oscillation will happens to this Q point to up and down. That is, when current is increasing, Q point will goes up. Current is decreasing, Q point will goes down. Correspondingly, voltage is increasing. When Q point is again goes up, current is increasing, voltage is decreasing. Like that, according to the AC signal, Q point will start to rotate, oscillate. Okay. So then again, then there is one problem. Up to where Q point can oscillate? Will it can oscillate up to whatever the voltage? No. It can increase, decrease only up to maximum this 14 voltage. Or it can increase maximum up to this 50 milliampere. Beyond that one, it will not give the value, because transistor is closed. If it is less than, that is near to 40 volt, 14 volt, transistor will be open circuit here. Open circuit means maximum voltage we are getting here, it is this VCC. Beyond that one, you won't get anything. If this transistor is short circuit, that is Q point is moves to here, transistor will be short circuit, then across that one you will get zero voltage. Below zero, we are not going to get. Or maximum current VCC by RC, beyond that we are not going to get. If you want to get beyond that one, what you have to do? You have to increase this VCC, that is supply volt. So now you may get the idea, that is this signal voltage, it is taking the energy or power from the supply voltage. So the maximum amplification can given by a circuit, that is the maximum DC voltage what we have given here. And that maximum DC voltage is the extreme Q point, VCE. And zero VCC is the minimum Q point. Corresponding, those currents also we have to consider. So, from where this Q point start to oscillate? If we are keeping this Q point here, it will oscillate this for positive half cycle. For negative half cycle, what will happen? This one will be clipped. You may see some amplification, it will be clipped somewhat like this. Signal is positive half cycle is there, negative is clipped like this. That is, one complete wave is there. This complete wave, when you are amplifying, its positive half will be there, negative half is clipped somewhat like this. Means upper portion is not there. What is the reason? It is going to cut off. If we are keeping the Q point here, the positive part may be clipped and negative half will be there. That is depends on the configuration. Okay. Anyway, so if we want to get the amplification for both the half cycle together, it is better to keep Q point at the midpoint, at the middle. So setting that Q point at the middle point, it is known as biasing, DC biasing. So we are fixing a particular voltage VBB or particular value. Corresponding particle IB is there. For this VBB and IB, for this VBB we have one IB. For that IB, a fixed value of VC and IC we have. So fixing that VC and IC exact particle location and keeping that one, it is known as DC biasing. After that, if we are giving AC signal, from that point Q point will go move up and down and we are getting amplified signal. I think you are clear. Thank you.